So welcome. Thank you very much for joining me. This is part of the Chamber's effort to help get out information to our membership about the various candidates and the offices that you guys are running for. And so I've hit the record button right now. So we're recording our conversation. And our plan is to post this along with the other interviews and your candidate videos by the end of the week. So about the time when ballots start to come out. So again, you guys are running for County Commission, District 1. And I thought what I'd like to do is have you do a self-introduction, a 1 minute self-introduction. I'm going to do the timing on my cell phone here, and I'll interrupt you when you are when you've passed your 1 minute. And then I have three questions for you guys to answer and a minute close, and that's kind of the format. So if we will move on, why don't we start with C. Davis, who's running for Thurston County Commissioner District 1. C, your 1 minute opening comments.
My name is C. Davis. I'm running for Thurston County Commissioner District 1. I've been in Olympia, Thurston County for 27 years. I worked in information technology for over 20 years, problem solving, working on big complex systems, seeing them from start to finish. They have to run stably and efficiently, and I was able to do that handily. I have also been a musician for 37 years, and I've owned two small businesses, two antique stores. I'm also a landlord, so I'm very familiar with housing issues. I'm familiar with building and development, retail, small business, and I have a degree from Evergreen in mathematics. So I'm very capable with logic and applying logic to big systems. My website is www.electcdavis.com. Thanks.
Thank you. And also joining us is Carolina Mejia. And so Carolina, if you do your 1 minute introduction, I greatly appreciate it. Thank you.
Yeah, my name is Carolina Mejia, and I'm running for Thurston County Commissioner in District 1. I'm a proud resident of Thurston County, a working mother, and I'm also a county employee. And I feel like that really will give a different insight to the county commission that's never been seen before. I decided to run for this position because after working for the county, I realized the policies that were being taken by the Board of County Commissioners were affecting me not only as an employee, but as a resident. And I realized we needed a change. We needed our community's voice to be really represented at the table. I started paying closer attention to the policies that were being taken, and that's why I decided to run, because I want to bring unity, accountability, and transparency back to our Board of County Commissions. My platform is on affordable housing, getting our budget under control, the environment, and a more inclusive government. I look forward to answering the questions that are today.
Thank you. So, I keep messing that up. So, Carolina, what are your economic development priorities for the region? 1 minute.
So, while I've been talking, right now we honestly have to get our small businesses back up and we have to give them our support. That's honestly one of the first things we need to do as a county is evaluate how we can do that. Second is also how we can support our rural areas and also our local farmers. One of the ways that I've talked with local farmers is having a processing center here in Thurston County and ways that we can install that will not be as, that will be more cost effective for the people here, and we'll be able to have grow and process our own food here in Thurston County.
Great, thank you. I'm going to do it again here. C, what are your economic development priorities for the region?
Thank you for the question. My priorities will be to create jobs by increasing growth and development in the county. The county has a great shortage of housing. This is driving up the price of housing. Regulation and taxation fees and great delays in the permitting process drives up the cost of housing. We can have a much more robust economy. We can generate lots more revenue without raising taxes. What we need to do is reduce regulation and reduce roadblocks to development. This will include things such as delisting the pocket gopher. We can petition to have this done, and we have a good chance of doing this. The pocket gopher is, by the way, an invasive species. It's also a destructive species. I have a binder, a several inch binder full of very scientifically juried studies showing the resilience of the creature. So we need to not let that prevent us from development.
Thank you. So see, the next question, we'll start with you. So with respect to revenues within the county budget, please provide your thoughts on the role of the private sector plays in sustaining and developing revenues for the Thurston County coffers.
Well, the private sector is the only sustainable economic driver of any system. Government is, in a sense, a form of leech economics, as opposed to the private sector, which is a wealth development form of economics. So that's, again, why we need to allow the private sector, small business, to flourish. When we overburden small business, we make it difficult, if not impossible, for them to survive. That has an impact on the consumer, and it has a very negative impact on jobs. So we need to get out of the way of small business so that they can do what they do best, and that's create wealth and prosperity and jobs in the community. Thanks.
Great, thank you. So Carolina, again, with respect to revenues within the county government budget, please provide your thoughts on the role the private sector plays in sustaining and developing revenues for Thurston County coffers.
I'm sorry, Doug, you kind of cut off there.
Okay.
Could you please repeat the question?
Yeah, again, so with respect to the revenues within county government and county's budget, please provide your thoughts on the role the private sector plays in sustaining and developing revenues for Thurston County's coffers.
Yeah, so the private sector, I mean, right now here in Thurston County, our biggest economy really is state employees. After that, state, city, county employees. After that, it's JBLM. And after that, it's the private sector. And so right now, really what we have to look at is how the private sector has been affected by the pandemic and what the county can do to really ease that burden. Because right now what we're seeing is a small business is having to apply for loans, and we really need to look at what the county can do, whether it be, have people help them to apply for those SBA loans, creating a local relief fund, or even deferring some financial burdens that are put by the county. And since we're doing really well on sales tax, it's something definitely that I feel like the county can look at, especially when it comes to property taxes for the small businesses that are currently going through this.
Great, thank you. So Carolina, the last question, and this is kind of a long one, so I'll try to read it slowly here. The Thurston County Economic Alliance's strategic plan includes, quote, target industry growth and innovation and a vision to support and stimulate growth in empirically defined, quote, clean and green target industries that provide critical jobs, generate significant taxable revenue, and attract new investment.
I apologize. I think some feedback from Mr. Davis' microphone came in, and I kind of cut you off there.
Okay. So we'll try it this way. Why don't both of you mute your microphones, and I'll read you the question because you both get the same question. So the question is, the Thurston Community Economic Alliance's strategic plan includes, quote, target industry growth and innovation, end quote, and a vision to support and stimulate growth in empirically defined clean and green target industries that provide critical jobs, generate significant taxable revenue, and attract new investments. So the question is, what skills and experiences would you bring to this endeavor, and what leadership role would you like to play in achieving this vision? So we'll start with Carolina, and then we'll go to Mr. Davis.
So I feel like campaigning has really brought me closer to a lot of people who are involved definitely in the community, solar community. And I've been talking with them we've talked a lot about the processing center and what that can do to the ag community and really making it green and just the tax breaks on that. I feel like a lot of people don't know just the tax breaks that people can get from that, just creating that stimulus, especially when it comes to green jobs. So I will bring the skills. I mean, I have policy background as well as a financial background. I think that will be very useful in making ways, making sure that we are cutting costs the best as possible, especially to fund other programs in the county. And I'm in full support of bringing green renewable jobs to Thurston County.
Great, thank you very much. Mr. Davis, you're up next, your response. 1 minute. Oh, you are still muted. There we go. Thank you.
My first time in college, I was a physics major. So that's when you asked for qualifications. So I'm very well versed on science as a foundation. I want to point out that we do have solar panel manufacturers in the county, and in other counties, we have nanotube carbon battery manufacturers. We also have biodiesel manufacturers in the county, and I think that we can encourage all of them, but we can encourage all clean businesses, and it goes back to making the place business friendly. We've just seen Boeing leaving many jobs from the state of Washington because the state's not being business friendly. We must be business friendly. We'll get clean development. We'll get good jobs that way. Thank you.
Great. Thank you. So, we'll switch now to the 1 minute close. If you will give us your 1 minute closing comments and your best pitch why members of the Thurston County Chamber of Commerce should be voting for you, that'd be great. And then we'll have Carolina close with the last word there. So, C.
As a voter, I feel that it's very important that I know what the positions are of the people I vote for. You as voters must feel the same way. It is important that you know what your candidate believes in and where they stand on the issues. There is no excuse for a candidate not divulging transparently and honestly where they stand on the issues. So I will stand here and say, I oppose building a new courthouse. We do not need to burden the taxpayers with $400 million spread over a 25-year levy, which is a generation and a half. Also want to say we have a significant problem with anarchist violence in the cities and spreading into the county here. So we need to increase law enforcement. With our sheriff's office, I will add 10 new deputies without raising taxes. I think that it's critically important that we remove the roadblocks to housing development and businesses in the county so that we can create good jobs in the county. Again, my website is www.electcdavis.com. I look forward to your questions and I will answer all your questions happily. Thank you.
Great, thank you, C. So Carolina, the last word, 1 minute close, please.
Well, thank you so much for your questions, and I hope I answered them to your satisfaction. My name is Carolina Mejia, and I am running because I want to bring unity, accountability, and transparency to our county. I have a background experience in the criminal justice system, which I believe is really important, as well as policy and finance. And I really want to bring the community's voices to the table and represent them. I'm going around and gathering opinions. So if you have any concerns, please email me or call me. I always look forward to hearing from community members and what the issues that are coming up in the commission matters. If you'd like to know more about me or my platform, my website is carolinaforthurston.com. Thank you.
Great. Thank you. Thank you both for joining me today. Like I said, I've been recording this and we will post it on the Chamber's webpage and make it part of our video voters guide. So something we're trying differently this year. And again, greatly appreciate it, your time and energy, and look forward to seeing you yet some more on the campaign trail. As you all know, the voters pamphlet comes out any day now, and then ballots next week, and voters actually have a little bit extra time to get their ballot in this year. So pretty interesting times. I appreciate you guys both kind of highlighting that. So, well, again, thank you very much, and we will stop recording.